So now we will see icons in CSS. So guys, basically icons can easily be added to your HTML page by using an icon library, and there are many popular icon libraries that you can use with the help of the HTML code. So guys, over here we have the font awesome icons that you can use, in which case you will be providing the script tag inside your HTML code and provide the icons inside the body tag in order to be displayed on the UI. And similarly, we have the bootstrap icons, in which case you have to provide the CSS file, that is the external CSS file using which you can provide the icons in your HTML page. And also we have the Google icons, which will help us in order to provide the external CSS file as well. So guys, we are going to use the Google icons this time, so we have to add the below line of code in the head section of the HTML page. So guys, basically when we add this particular line inside the head section of the HTML page, you don't have to download any of the icons to display them, but simply you have to refer to them by using the name of that icon. So guys, let me just copy this line of code over here, that is the link tag, which is of the relation style sheet and having the href to this particular URL that you can see. So let me just copy this file and provide it inside our HTML file over here. I'll simply remove the previous lines of code that we had written, and after this external style sheet, in this case we will provide this line of code which will help us in order to display the Google icons. So guys, over here we have provided the line of code inside the head section of the HTML page. Now guys, simply we can use this particular syntax in order to provide the icon on the page over here. So guys, let me just copy this line of code in this case, and over here inside the body tag we will have the paragraph tag, and we will say below are some of the Google icons. So guys, basically we are having the simple text over here, and then after this we are going to use this particular syntax, that is having the I tag over here, and simply we are going to have the class attribute in this case, which is going to have the value as material icons, and simply we can provide the name of the icon that we want to display. So guys, in this case it is the cloud icon that we are going to display. So let me just save this file now and try reloading this page once again on the browser. So as you can see, below are some of the Google icons paragraph is getting displayed, and this is the Google icon that is getting displayed with the help of this line of code that we had written inside the head section over here. Now guys, similarly if you want to display the icon for the computer, so what you can do is simply I'll copy the line of code in this case and paste it over here, and instead of having the cloud we will simply say computer in this case. Let me just save this file now and try reloading this page once again on the browser. So as you can see, the computer icon is getting displayed over here. Apart from this, let us say we want to display the home icon. So simply I'm going to copy this and paste this line of code, and over here we are going to provide the home keyword. So let me just save this file now and try reloading this page once again on the browser. So as you can see, home icon is getting displayed. Now guys, how you will come to know what is the name that you are supposed to provide for a particular icon? Because not all the words that you will provide over here will have the icon in the Google icons website. So guys, what you can do is, I have also provided the link over here to the Google icons. So this is the link for the icons that are related to the fonts.google.com website. So let us check this URL over here. So I'll just go to this page in this case. So as you can see, if you scroll down, you will see all the list of icons that is present over here. So in case you want to display the settings icon, simply you have to provide the settings name over here inside your code in this particular syntax. So let me just copy the syntax and paste this over here, and instead of home we will simply say settings in this case. Let me just save this file now and try reloading this page once again on the browser. So as you can see, the settings icon is getting displayed. Now guys, what if we miss out the last S over here and simply we say setting in this case? So what will happen in such cases where the name of the icon is not matching with the list of icons that are present in the Google fonts over here? So let me just save this file now and try reloading this page once again on the browser. So since the name is not matching, the setting icon is not getting displayed in this case. So guys, it is very important that you match the name over here inside the Google fonts icon according to your requirements and display them by using this particular syntax that we have seen over here. So I'll simply change it to settings in this case. Let me just save this file now and try reloading this page once again on the browser. So as you can see, the settings icon is getting displayed over here. Now let us display the search icon as well inside our HTML page. So simply I'm going to copy the syntax and paste this over here, and instead of settings we will say search in this case. Let me just save this file now and try reloading this page once again on the browser. So as you can see, the search icon is getting displayed over here. So guys, in this way you can easily include Google icons on your HTML page just by including this particular line of code over here that is related to Google fonts. So guys, comment in the comment section below whether you have learned something out of this video. Please make sure that you like this video so that it reaches to more people, and subscribe to the channel so that you get the notifications on upcoming videos as well. The next video that we are going to talk about is an exercise on text properties, font and icons in CSS. So stay tuned.